Father Khan's death did nothing to relieve Scorpion's pain. The loss of his kin still weighed heavily upon him. For reasons he could neither explain nor understand, he was drawn to the home of the Shirai Ryu. Standing amid the rubble in solemn contemplation, Scorpion was visited by apparitions of his fallen comrades, who revealed the true mastermind behind their brutal deaths. Enraged, he returned to the Netherrealm. As the spirits of his kin immobilized Quan Chi, Scorpion slew him, finally avenging their deaths. Kang's request was granted. He was made a god, a new protector of Earthrealm. That Kung Lao had unlocked memories of his past life. The Kung Lao that stood before Raiden was in fact the reincarnation of the great Kung Lao, who had been defeated by Goro 500 years ago, yet accomplished in the present what he could not in the past. After the victory over Shao Kahn, Sub-Zero learned from Raiden the truth, that the Lin Kuei were ultimately responsible for the deaths of both Sub-Zero's and Scorpion's families. Enraged, Sub-Zero offered Scorpion a chance to share in his quest for vengeance. With the might of fire and ice combined, they were a storm of vengeful fury as they cut down their foes. Once justice had been done, Sub-Zero and Scorpion disappeared into legend, emerging from obscurity only to avenge the innocent. The forces of darkness will never stop this deadly alliance. Restoring her realm to its former glory. The many races of Outworld were impressed. Not only had Sindel defeated Shao Kahn, but she had shown great leadership in chaotic times. Under Sindel's governance, the realms of Edenia and Outworld remain merged in spirit. To Outworld, determined to reunite with his past. Queen Sindel and Princess Katana were shocked to learn the truth, that trapped among the many spirits within Ermac was their husband and father, King Jaren. Though he would never be the Jaren they once knew, Ermac would forever serve and protect his queen and the Edenian people. Shao Kahn, Reptile was feared by all. He forced Shang Tsung to regenerate his Raptor race. The process took agonizing months, but soon Reptile heard the snarls of young broodlings throughout the flesh pits. Eventually, Shang Tsung had created an army of Raptor warriors bred to serve Reptile. They stormed the realm, killing any Tarkatan, Shokan, or Centaur who opposed Reptile's rule. The intoxicating feeling of reuniting with his people blinded Reptile to the suffering of his former comrades. Reptile was home once more. Discovered the truth about the Luna, but rather than slay her as well, she took pity on her half-sister. She offered Melina a home within the Edenian aristocracy. She was, after all, of royal blood. Melina cautiously accepted her sister's invitation. With Melina and Jade at her side, Kitana formed a fighting force dedicated to bringing justice to the realm. Never again will a warlord arise to create such terror. She slipped into a dreamlike state and found herself walking in an unknown realm. As she explored, the surroundings shifted and changed. Jade approached a lone figure who stood in the distance, a shimmering woman. She She did not reveal her name, but spoke with an air of regal authority. Through the minds of countless mortals, the woman had been watching events as they unfolded over the centuries. She informed Jill that Shao Kahn's death was an outcome that must be reimagined. Jill was defenseless as the woman possessed her body and emerged in the waking world. Melina killed the Emperor in a bit of deranged fury. But she was unaware that her victory resulted from Shang Tsung's designs. He had imbued her with the ability to drain Shao Kahn's dark magic, rendering him vulnerable. Now Shang Tsung was ready to execute the next phase of his plan, murder Melina and take Shao Kahn's power for himself. But Melina instinctively wielded her new dark power against the sorcerer. Shang Tsung's aim came quickly. Melina absorbed his soul, multiplying her strength. She then set out to pay an even bigger prize, a soul. Nightwolf returned to his home, seeking the elders' help and reconnecting to the spirit world. During their ritual, his wolf returned to him, changed. Shao Kahn had tethered his soul to the wolf spirit in order to cheat death. Now corrupted with Shao Kahn's evil, Nightwolf has transformed into his animality, his bite converting his victims into subservient lycanthropes. Through Nightwolf, Shao Kahn will conquer Earthrealm, one mortal at a time. Shaolin monks. The Lin Kuei were defeated, though Sektor was not counted among the dead. Cyrax was offered sanctuary at the Wuxi Academy, where he has begun a new life as an honorable warrior of peace.
There's two more than two matches. And in this part, at least.
Shinnok, Quan Chi, and the Brotherhood of Shadow were unprepared as the forces of chaos overwhelmed them, leaving the underworld severely weakened. Satisfied with his work, the cleric, Havoc, returned. return to the realm of chaos. No Cybok remained to seize control of the Netherrealm. Were helpless against his shapeless form as he lashed out with rage, killing them all. His murder avenged, he returned to his human form, remembering nothing of his former life. Now aware of his true identity, Smoke understands he is no mere assassin. His destiny has been revealed. Gave him unparalleled access to global communications. Using Despite telling the world that he was simply doing his job, Stryker was made a hero for saving Earth from invasion. He received both the key to the city and the Congressional Medal of Freedom. Press and paparazzi hounded his every move. His biography spent a year on the bestseller lists. Stryker action figures flew off the shelves and into every young boy's hand. But when approached by Hollywood for the rights to his story, Stryker put his foot down. Never would he allow himself to be portrayed by John Taylor. Shang Tsung voraciously consumed Shao Kahn's soul, absorbing his immense power. Overwhelmed by his newfound sorcery, he fled to Outworld. Moments before suicide, Shang Tsung was visited by the Righteous. The mentor of warriors offered to teach him to control the dark magic, but for a special purpose. Liu Kang had become a god. Power had corrupted him, transforming him into a tyrant. He needed to be stopped. After rigorous training, Shang Tsung mastered the one technique that could finish Liu Kang. Vengeance would finally be. Direction of the wind and divided his soul. placing one part in each of them. Through these new heroes, Raiden can combat the forces of darkness in four places at once.
Oh, he's the third character to, as he is the third character that I have fought with without losing more than twice in Shao Kahn. Excellent.
Say, why is there no narration? This has gotta be a glitch, hasn't it? Cyber Shao Kahn. Okay. That's interesting. But what I have a moment like that since I played as Quan Chi.
Realized her unwitting role is one to bring ruin. She avenged her fallen master. Having served her oath, Scarlet disappeared into the shadows, awaiting Shao Kahn's reward. Magical sword drew the souls of Kenshi's ancestors into itself, leaving Shang Tsung a withered husk. His vendetta fulfilled, Kenshi left Shang Tsung to die, alone and powerless.
You are done now, Shao Kahn.
Return to immortality. From the dream